What's up, everyone? I recorded this video on Saturday, March 5th, 2022. It's 9:41 a.m. and it's 77 Fahrenheit, 25 Celsius here in Miami, Florida. And I'm going to be making a video today showing you the public transit system of Miami, Florida with the buses. I'm in the Little Havana neighborhood on Northwest 17th Avenue near West Flagler Street. Here's the bus station, the bus for the number 17. And I'm going to the Coral Gables neighborhood because there's an event today called the Carnival on the Mile. It's only for this weekend, so I want to check it out. But in order to get there from here, I need to take two buses, the number 17 and then transfer to the 24. I'm not exactly sure when this bus is gonna arrive, but we'll find out. Hopefully it's not too long. Okay, I have my Google Maps app open. It says that it's going to arrive at in about 9 minutes. It's also a weekend, so I do expect the buses to run a little bit slower. So Google Maps is telling me I should arrive there at 10:25 a.m. And the way this fare works is it's a set fare. I have the website open now. The regular fare for this bus is $2.25. A discounted fare is $1.10. And if you transfer to another bus, there's a free transfer within 3 hours of the time of the first use, but you can't use it on the same route. Also, if you transfer to the rail system from the bus and vice versa, it's for free. The way I've been paying for the bus system is just using my smartphone or tapping my card on the reader. They have the contactless payment system, so you could use any eligible credit card or debit card which has the contactless payment feature. I think there's also a transit card that you can use and reload. I've seen some people use that, but I don't really know how that works. And you could also pay with cash. I like how this bus is labeled 17 because it runs along 17th Avenue. So that's very convenient. I also have the bus map here. There's another one, the 27. It runs on 27th Avenue, 37, 37th Avenue. So that makes sense. I'm glad they did that. we'll find out just how efficient Miami's public transportation system is. I've had a few viewers comment that Miami's public transit system is underdeveloped, but we'll just find out how well it is serving the community with this video. I actually took the bus from downtown Miami to Miami Beach yesterday, and not gonna lie, it was very busy. And when we got to the transit center, there were even people who weren't able to get onto the bus because there was no room. Quite windy here. Now let's see, if you were to drive to this area that I'm trying to get to, the Miracle Mile, it would take 14 minutes by car, but by public transit it says it's going to take 36 minutes. What is a good thing is that these apps, Google Maps and even the transit app and some other ones, they let you know where the bus is, so you don't have to wait out and guess where it is, like me. Actually, I know where it is, but I choose to sit here and wait for the bus anyway. I'm just curious, I wonder how much a car service would cost to get to the Miracle Mile. Alright, an Uber to get there is $10.23. I find that Uber in Miami is a lot more affordable than many other places I've traveled to. I'm not really too certain how much these Uber drivers are making though, with fares that low, especially since the price of gasoline's been going up. I've seen a few gas stations here that they were really approaching $4 a gallon. bus says it's coming in 2 minutes now, but I don't really see it traveling the amount of distance that it says it will in 2 minutes. It still hasn't even crossed the Miami River yet. And looks like it's about 3 stops away. Looks like the bus hasn't even moved from its location on the map. It would be nice if this was the only bus I needed to take, but I do need to transfer. If the bus runs at this rate for the rest of my trip, as well as the connecting bus, I don't think Google Maps predictions are going to be accurate. Oh, there's the bus now. I'm going to use Apple Pay to pay the fare. So it looks like I need to get off at Southwest 13th Avenue and then transfer to the 24. I'm not really in a rush to get to this festival because most of the activity won't really be there until the early afternoon. Okay, here we go. Here's the bus. It's coming. The number 17 bus to the Vizcaya station. Good morning. Okay, so this is the bus. Looks pretty clean. and got a information board there. It tells you the temperature, the route, some other info like the streets and the stop it's gonna make. And it's air conditioned quite well. Here's the bus stop I just got on from. Braking. There's a lot of amazing murals in Little Havana. In another 2 or 3 blocks or so, we're going to be passing the famous Calle Ocho. It's the most well-known street in Little Havana. Stop that you want to do it at. That shark wheel. too many stops right now. I would assume if this is a weekday, people will be requesting stops a lot more frequently. Where the bus is going to make the turn on Southwest 22nd Street, co-named Coral Way. So I'm going to have to request the stop soon. Get off and another all the stop after the next one I need to get off. And hopefully this bus doesn't take too long, the 24 bus. Thank you. Okay. So that was the number 17 bus for Miami-Dade County. Now I need to go over there to transfer to the other bus, the 24. Except there's no crosswalk here, so I'm gonna have to do this pretty carefully. Oh, there is a cut for a crosswalk over there, so let me use that. This is actually a pretty nice street. I like all the different trees on the median here. Okay, here's the bus stop for 24. Looks like I can get 24 limited. I think both buses, they go to the same place. Let's see, 24. Oh yeah, they both go to where I need to go anyway. Oh wait, it runs Monday through Saturday. Wow. So I need to get off at the Ponce de Leon Boulevard station. This 24? Wait. It skipped me. Oh, come on. Oh my gosh. Well, if that's the kind of service I expect from the Miami bus here. Well, the next one's in 12 minutes, it says, according to Google Maps. I had my back turned too, so that may have been a reason why the bus driver just skipped over me. He didn't think I was seriously waiting for the bus, but I don't know, that was kind of hard to tell. Yep. The bus just skipped over me. Oh man. Wait, I think I could take this one too. The Coral Way trolley. But that doesn't actually stop here. Boy, does it? Yeah, it doesn't. Those trolleys are completely free to ride. They're actually buses because they're dressed up like trolleys. They're still on wheels, rubber wheels. No electricity involved. And to think that at any point in this journey, I could have just ordered an Uber and been there already for about 10 bucks. So yeah, I think I kind of have to agree with people who say that Miami's public transportation system is underdeveloped. At least this one is the limited stop bus. It's only two stops away. It's It's only 7 stops to the Miracle Mile. Got a good idea, ride a bike there. Wish I had one already. I think the bus is almost here. According to transit, it says it's 3 minutes away. I also wonder how this transfer will work since I used my smartphone. If it will detect the same payment method used twice and give me a free transfer. Also, if you use a credit or debit card on the reader. I'm sure the system is smart enough to detect a transfer. I don't really know how cash passengers will be able to prove that they get a transfer. Maybe the bus driver gives them a receipt or something. I even think the transit app was off there. Where is this bus? Alright, bus is coming. Wait, that's 17. I need 24. So. I think she paid with the Miami pass that they use for the buses. That's my bus over there, 24. Coral Way Limited bus. Okay. Good morning. All right. All right. So here's the bus. Not too many people on this bus at all. Information board is off. Well, let me switch seats. There's like this graphic in the way that obstructs the view. Since the information board is off, I'm gonna have to rely on my phone or figure out where I need to get off and see how close I am. Air conditioner works well on this bus, same as the last one. I saw most people, they just tap their cards in the payment system. One person used a smartphone but had to do it some multiple times. I had issues with my smartphone payment because it didn't recognize my face ID. I had to put in my passcode to pay. $1.29 for regular gas.
Wow.
It's a lot of money. Almost there. If I had to guess, probably another 3-4 minutes. Pretty much here already. Maybe just another like few blocks. The bus will turn and we'll get off. There's a lot of traffic because the city of Coral Gables closed off the street there for the festival. Everyone here needs to make a right turn. And this traffic's only going to get worse later in the day. Guess I'll get off here. Okay. All right, I'm finally here after like a 50-minute trip on the 17 bus and then the 24, the Miracle Mile. It's right over here, and I'm gonna explore this festival. Anyway, Hope you enjoy that experience on Miami-Dade's public transit system. Smash the like button, subscribe. I'll see you later. Bye.